boundary of human achievement, the new frontier.
It's just a cough.
Yeah, right. And the earth is flat.
Treat your cough seriously with Robitussin CF Max. Nothing lasts longer and treats more symptoms for your cough, cold, and flu. Robitussin, because it's never just a cough.
In a few moments, you will have an experience which will seem completely real. It will be the result of your subconscious fears transformed to your conscious awareness. Warning, this tape must not be played by government personnel. It can be extremely harmful and result in severe trauma. You have 5 seconds to terminate this tape. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hold him. Now you listen to me, you hillbilly punk who thinks the world's still round. I'm here to tell you it's not. It's flat.
Lexi, tell us something interesting.
Okay. The earth is flat, and a witch stole his pants.
Flat Earth expert Mark Sargent thinks the moon landing was a hoax.
Technically, the moon itself is a hoax.
Right, but betting with Sportsbet's new iPhone app?
I could do this standing on my head.
Thanks, Gravity. Sportsbet's new iPhone app. It's foolproof.
I know how we're different. Do you believe the Earth is flat?
I know it's flat. I walk on it.
Holy sh**.
Do you think the flat Earth is flat?
It's a flat world after all.
Smoke weed every day.
Broadcasting straight to you from a large spaceship currently at war with mainstream science. Meanwhile, the peanut gallery is thinking of all the taxpayers' wasted money this year. NASA, aid to the Ukraine, shrimp farming in Arizona, but nothing compares to the government funding almost $120,000 to research if Thanos could actually snap his fingers with the Infinity Gauntlet on. Is that real? I'm going to have to get clarification on that. I don't know if that's a real study. Might be. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Strange World, where the truth is often stranger than fiction. I am your host, Mark Sargent, creator of Flat Earth Clues, which propose that all of us are living inside a Truman Show enclosed structure thousands of miles wide. Just Google Flat Earth Clues. If you can't find it, well, you're just not very good at the internet in 2022. See what I did there? Currently, the show is on Tuesday nights at 7 Pacific, 10 Eastern. And yes, Caroline, if it does not look at date for the last time this year, December 27th, 2022, then you are listening to a rerun, the last rerun of the year, before we get to that really weird date of 2023. Quote of the day goes exactly like this. It's a movie quote. It's better to be on the inside, maybe be able to change something, than be on the outside and not be able to change anything. Who said that? Maybe the chat room will figure that out. And by the way, Peanut actually said, Fed's funded study proving Thanos couldn't snap his fingers while wearing the gauntlet. Wow. Thank you, Peanut. Seriously, that kept me up at night. No, I actually never thought about that till just now. My co-host, she's lovely, she's sassy, and she's one of the biggest flat earth rock stars ever. Karen B from the channel of the same name. What's going on, Karen?
Not a whole lot, Mark.
Yeah, you look very nice tonight in your blue-ish sports hoodie. Where'd you get that? Have you always had that?
I was born with it on. Actually.
No. No, I mean, did you get it for the holidays? Was it something recent?
No, it's old. You just
threw it on. Oh, you're doing the modest. It's just something I threw on. It's fine. Don't make a big deal about it. Well, it looks nice.
Thank you, Mark.
Well, just saying, it's different because it's not absolutely black, so we can see you. You're not a floating head. As it were. Say, Karen, being the current queen of flat earth, it must be hard to find flat earth friends. That's not true. Do you know an easy way to find cool people like yourself and solid info about our stationary horizontal level plane? Asked David Weiss.
Why, yes, that would be the Flat Earth Sun, Moon, and Zodiac Clock app.
Sure enough, it's the perfect gift for friends, family, and complete strangers. Watch the featured video every day for 2 weeks and see what happens. It'll be the best $2.99 you ever spent. Don't forget, you can also find this program on BitChute, Brideon, Rockfin, Rumble, and social media platforms that haven't been invented yet. YouTube is not the end of Flat Earth. It is just the beginning. Shout outs, obviously, to Flat Earther Stephen Carpenter of the Deftones. Support the Flat Earth cause and get the coolest hoodies ever. Go to the strong.family, won't you? And of course, best wishes to Suzanne, who is probably getting ready to get on a plane and head to Korea. Mm-hmm. And when she comes back, will there be Truth Smacks? I think so.
Yeah. Truth Smacks shall return.
Yes, they will. And the commercial, even though it's not going to be on this show, is still going to be on my channel. It's called In Memory of Truth Smacks. And you can find it. Just type in Truth Smacks and you'll be able to find it there. And see, meetups. You know what? I don't think. Do we have any meetups?
Well, Brian is having a meetup. There's going to be a meetup with a bunch of flat earthers in Greenville, South Carolina. Let me go.
How do I not know this one?
I don't know. Probably because he didn't tell you about it.
Oh, but you didn't tell
me about it. Sunday, January 15th at the City Tavern in Main Street in Greenville, South Carolina at 5 p.m.
Cool.
Dr. Law and Christian Knapp and That Flat Fellow.
Nice.
And Brian Stavely.
Flat Earth Meetup also, if you're going to be in the New Zealand area, outside of Auckland, January 2nd. And the promo for that is on my channel. And the guy who's putting it on has a P1000. He's going to be showing it off to people like he always does when he's down there. And Peanuts says that I got another one in my email just now. Way to send me. Guys, don't send me these while I'm on air. Let's see. This is Jesse. Hope you're doing well. Had a good Christmas. Next meetup will occur Saturday, we got time, January 14th at Charleston's Restaurant, 3409 South Broadway, number 400, Edmond, Oklahoma. Location is 15 minutes north of downtown Oklahoma City by car. RSVP by calling Jesse at 857-344-6209. Or if you're afraid of the telephone, email him at 300kmileprius@gmail.com. Jesse does a lot of these, does a nice job.
Also, there's also another meetup going the same day, Saturday. Is that Saturday, January 14th?
Is
that what you just said?
Yes.
January 14th.
That is Saturday the 14th. Yeah.
Yes, Saturday, January 14th. There's also going to be a Flat Earth meetup in Tucson, the Tucson Flat Earther meetup in Arizona, Milagrosa Cross Canyons hike And you can email truthernation@protonmail.com. Details
go to protonmail.com.
truthernation@protonmail.com. And I will also post this on my website. I just got the email though.
So I love how people are just like sending it. Oh, you get to me. It's like, guys, send it.
Sent it yesterday, but I haven't had a chance to update the website yet.
All right. That one's completely on Karen. That's completely her fault. Mine, I have reason to yell at people. And by the way, Peanut Gallery will be at the Oklahoma meetup, he says, between breaths of smoke. Can't even see him in there. It's just smoke and him waving.
And also, I see someone asking about baby news for Austin and Kai Witsit. Austin Witsit, who's a Globuster, and his wife Kai were expecting a baby, and that baby was born. Yes. December 21st, 2022, their little baby girl was born. So yes, they had their baby, happy, healthy, everything went great. Fantastic.
The early bids right now are about 35,000. That's American. And I know, seriously, I've gotten really serious offers from the Ivory Coast, and they say they will pay triple if the eyes stay blue. All right, let's move on to, but that's not true at all. It's double. Is there anything else before we get all the meetups? Best wishes to the child. And Thanos cannot snap his fingers with the glove on because it's a suit of armor. Is that it?
I guess.
All right. Good night, everybody. No. Okay. So the show is called Changing the Narrative. And I did it because it was a slow news week. And two, because I've been scraping for stuff to watch. What dropped during the holiday season was season three of the Tom Clancy Jack Ryan television series. And I'm not kidding you, I'm going to frame this, and spoiler alerts for some people that are watching, although I'm not giving a ton of spoilers, is that basically, if you know anything about Tom Clancy and the Jack Ryan narrative, it's a show about how the CIA does good work. But seriously, that's what it's about. CIA good, everyone else bad. That's really what the series is and the movies. However, in this case, it really has become apparent. They're not even trying to hide it anymore. The CIA is writing the show now. So I've got a little mini rant, and normally I would have slides to go with this, and I will release the slide version tomorrow. I'm going to put it all together tomorrow morning. I'll release it. But I didn't want Karen and I to start arguing over which slide was which, because there's a bunch of them. So I'm just going to read you the audio part of it, and you can fill in the visuals for yourself. So you ready? How to change a narrative, brought to you by the CIA, or sponsored by the CIA, you pick. I have to frame this a bit for context. As you know, I try to absorb all media and movies. I especially enjoy the smart ones. Stories with very few plot holes have been my favorite for decades. With that in mind, let's take a look at a plot from some years ago. Plot goes something like this. The deputy director of Central Intelligence tries to stop a crisis concerning the Middle East peace process where Palestinian and former East German terrorists, otherwise known as ex-Nazis, conspire to bring the United States and the Soviet Union, yes, I said that right, into nuclear war. If you are a movie fan, you will probably recognize this as the Sum of All Fears by Tom Clancy, widely considered one of the best military and spy writers of all time. A little backstory on Tom Clancy should be mentioned here. As a young man, he was not allowed into the military because he was extremely nearsighted, so he reluctantly became an insurance agent and wrote military stories in his spare time. How's that for dumb luck? The first four things he wrote were Hunt for Red October, Patriot Games, Clear and Present Danger, and The Sum of All Fears, all of which became successful films and established Tom Clancy as a quality brand, all caps. If you were looking for a solid American spy thriller, he was it. And at no point did Tom Clancy paint the Soviet Union, now Russia, as the enemy. They were always the stoic rivals. Did the US and the USSR compete for some of the same goals? Yes. But in the end, neither side came out swinging. The closest Tom Clancy ever got to a full-on world conflict was with The Sum of All Fears. It's in the title, after all, because everyone was afraid of the fight between the two biggest kids on the block. In the movie, A radical East German faction tricked both sides into firing on each other by staging a Russian false flag attack on an American NFL game, destroying the stadium and killing thousands. In the end, Jack Ryan and the CIA discovered the plot and defused the situation at the last minute, of course. But the key point I want to make here is that the Russians had nothing to do with it. They were innocent bystanders. The book was written in 1991. And the movie starring Ben Affleck and Morgan Freeman was released in 2002. Lived that 20 years ago, with the plot intact. But today, that narrative has changed drastically, and for a very specific reason. Why? Simple. Most Americans either don't know or had forgotten that Tom Clancy died almost 10 years ago in Ireland, no less. Turns out he had cancer and a bad heart, and it gave out at the relatively young age of 66. If he was alive today, he'd be 76, be fine. And when he passed away, his intellectual property rights were immediately sold off to the highest bidders, which is why you may not have known that. Keep the product alive and subliminally hot sex, the creator is still alive. You see, the Tom Clancy brand has become a machine that keeps on rolling forward. Multiple video game series, a newer movie that was not written by him, and now a television series in its third season. All they have to do is put Tom Clancy above the title and people will tune in. And I tuned in as well. I was a fan of the first four movies, and even though the Amazon series Jack Ryan is more or less a retread of the early books, it was nice to see the character back in a modern-day setting. But something about season three, which was just released, caught my attention. The story had changed, and the new narrative was so glaring, I had to talk about it and call out the CIA project handlers. You know who you are. Two floors down and down the hall. The sum of all fears villain in 2002 was a group of wealthy ex-Nazi extremists who wanted the US and Soviet Union to destroy each other so they could create a new European superstate out of the ashes. Now, there are no European extremists at all. Now, there is only Russia. The news story is that Russian extremists who long for the glory days of the USSR are going to stage a military coup, overthrowing the Russian president while simultaneously staging an American false flag attack, blowing up a small Russian city near the border, kicking off a war with the US. Russia would then reestablish the Soviet Union, and while they are at it, take over all of Europe in their never-ending quest for world domination. In addition, as if that wasn't enough, Russia is already at war with Ukraine in the show. And the false flag is using a stolen American Patriot missile. And the lead female character is practically a dead ringer for the Prime Minister of Sweden. But in this, it's the Czech Republic President Alina Kovac. Remember Sweden in 2022? Little review. They were going to join NATO and Russia was pressuring them not to. Yeah, that is exactly what is going on in season three of this show. Only it's the Czech Republic. So it's not an issue because it's not Sweden. Even though they look the same. This is, by the way, what you can do when you own the rights to an intellectual property. Amazon owns the television rights to the character Jack Ryan and can spin any story they want with him in it. And in this case, it's somewhat ironic that the story here is being laid out by the actual CIA, who is also the lead group in the fictional series Who Saves the World. And the two narratives that subliminally hot sex you might have missed. The first is that if there is a military coup in Russia, the Americans had nothing to do with it, even though there are employee handbooks in the agency on exactly how to overthrow governments. A side note is the continuing illusion that the US only overthrows small nations in tropical climates, even though privately we would like nothing more than to overthrow them all. The second and more, I'm going to get in so much trouble for this. I almost see the headlights coming up the driveway. The second and more important narrative is that if something big blows up in Russia and every bit of evidence, including the missile that did it, points to the Americans, well, we didn't do it. The Russians did it to themselves. The average viewer, and by that I mean people who do not listen to this broadcast, may not catch that. But it is clear that making Russia the big villain is still on the table. In conclusion, is this some of the finest predictive programming yet? I give it a thumbs up. Yes. Time will tell as we move into 2023. Stay tuned. There you go. So if you wait till tomorrow, you will get the slide version of that. And I may not be as animated, but yeah, I absolutely believe that. I'm just sitting there watching the show. It was only an 8-part series, and I'm getting to the end. I'm just going, you such and such is really, this is what you're going to do. You're just going to say the CIA is in fact, the last frame. Let me end with this. The last frame of the show was them. If you know anything about the lobby of the main CIA headquarters in Langley, it's got that big symbol on the floor, this giant 30-foot wide symbol. It's them walking across it. You know, the good guys won, you know, dramatic music as they're walking off. It might as well have been a glorified cop show that just solved a major crime. It's like, we CIA saved the world once again. The message should have been, we saved Russia from themselves. You guys are killing me. I don't think there was a single objection. It was almost like they were giving them instructional. It's like it had multiple messages. Also the message to the prime minister of Sweden saying, hey, by the way, we're good. Both sides are working. Yeah, but we're the good guys. Everyone knows that. America's the good guys. Russia, right. They're the plotting, you know, bad guys that people laugh at because they're so obvious in the way they do things. We're the clever. We can beat them at every turn because we're so sharp. You know,
you're
we can make them trip up all the time. It's like, oh, here comes Russia. Rah, rah, rah. You know, all we have to do is stick a foot out. That's it. They trip and fall. Everybody laughs at Russia. Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right. So that was basically my little mini rant. The other story, we might as well bring this up. How much time we got? We got all sorts of time. Let's bring up the story because I want to read part of this. Remember a couple weeks ago when I said that Fortune magazine, which is basically a financial periodical, mm-hmm. when they have their own health section. And when I look for top of the line, high caliber information about health, that's who I would turn to is Fortune magazine. Not anybody else.
The money people, right?
The money people. That's who I want to talk to. And seriously, they've got their top five things: nutrition, burnout, aging, COVID-19, and caregiving. Okay, so let me read the headline here. Because they can cover COVID all the time, and I like the their little graphic that's in there. COVID isn't just infecting you; it could be reactivating viruses that have been dormant in your body for years.
My God.
Yep. So again, how they're leading this in, I mean, the person that's writing this, there's a psychological paradigm behind this, but you'll get what I'm saying. So the opening line is, you had COVID a few months ago and recovered, but things still aren't quite right. Okay. When you stand up, you feel dizzy and your heart races. Even routine tasks leave you feeling spent. And what was once a good night's sleep no longer feels refreshing. Long COVID, right? That's their opener. It may not be so simple, really? Because you told us it was simple and you said it was long COVID. Now it's not anymore? Okay. A mild or even asymptomatic case of COVID can cause reservoirs of some viruses you previously battled to reactivate, potentially leading to symptoms of chronic fatigue syndrome, a condition that resembles long COVID, according to a recent study, blah, blah, blah. Researchers found herpes viruses like Epstein-Barr, one of the drivers behind mono, circulating in unvaxxed patients. Oh no, who had COVID. Uh-huh. By the way, that also drives me nuts. Who are the unvaxxed people that are getting tested?
Right.
What's the point? I don't know that many people that have got, especially on a regular basis, especially in our community. You know, most of our community is completely unvaxxed.
Right.
And anyway, in patients with chronic fatigue syndrome, antibody responses were stronger, signaling an immune system struggling to fight off the lingering viruses. Oh my God, just goes on and on. The nebulous condition with no definitive cause leads to symptoms like fatigue, brain fog. Wait a minute, wasn't that in a movie with Tom Hanks? No, that was brain cloud. That was Joe versus the Volcano. You remember that movie from a long time ago? Yes. With Meg Ryan? He had a brain cloud. Well, apparently it's a real thing now. Brain fog, dizziness when moving, and unrefreshing sleep. Oh, God. Anyway, it just goes on and on about how they're basically justifying you not feeling well. If you're not feeling well, it's obviously that COVID is re-triggering a whole bunch of stuff in you. And I don't even know if they're saying you're ever going to get better. Do they say?
Probably not. Why would they ever say that? There's no profit in people getting better.
That's true.
Let's just let everybody think they're going to be sick forever.
Yeah, I don't know. What was the treatment?
Everybody's going to be sick forever. Everybody's going to be sick forever.
I'm looking. We don't have enough evidence to support that. What treatment? There's a quote by Fauci. We very well might be a post-viral syndrome associated with COVID. Yeah. Anyway, it's quite a long article. They talked to a whole bunch of people. Yeah, few options for now. So basically, they're just justifying it. They're saying, yeah, you feel crappy, but so do a lot of other people. But trying to pin it, yeah, I don't run into all these things that I'm reading here with unvaxxed people. I just don't. Every person, and I know we probably shouldn't drag this on too much, is every person that I've heard that has felt terrible over months and/over a year, they all got the shot. Have you heard sort of the same thing? Kind of?
Yeah. Pretty much.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
And it's not just mild stuff. Like, oh, I kind of feel a little off today. It's like, no, they feel terrible. If I have to hear one more story about a heart issue, or a blood issue, whatever. Anyway, so that was the story. I don't really have a clown world for you, because nothing's been happening. The only clown world that was just kind of terrible was the Southwest Airlines, which is they canceled almost all their flights. I do not know. My prediction for Southwest is if you burn that many people during Christmas, the word's going to get out, and by summer, you are going to have a lot of people wanting to fly with you. Doesn't matter how cheap your prices are. I don't know if they're going to roll those dice. Because being stranded in an airport during a cold snap where there's nowhere to go and you have to scramble to other... You basically, the only way out people were doing where they were just buying any tickets they could on any airlines. You know what happens when you try to buy airline tickets at the last minute.
Yeah.
Cha-ching!
Right, you're right, exactly.
Where people are having forced to buy business class tickets and first class tickets just to get the hell out. It's like, isn't that the kids' college money? We got to get home. Yeah, not good. So whatever's going Southwest Airlines, can't wait to see how that pans out. They're stockholders. Their stock prices today must be terrible. Somebody look that up. Peanut, look that up. Would Southwest lose their shirt in the stock market today? Because they're public. Oh, really? Peanut knows somebody that's stuck in Denver because of Southwest. I'm sorry. I feel bad. I shouldn't have said something. But yeah, Denver was one of the biggest cities.
Wow.
That was getting crushed to where something like 80 to 90% of the flights, they just canceled them. And they were blaming it on, you know, the pilots had already spent, you know, because pilots can only fly so many hours a month. Mm-hmm. And they had already maxed out. And then there were people calling in sick because of the virus of unknown origin. Because that was the other thing we talked about before the show, which is people are... Stock market, Southwest Airlines. Yeah, I should probably take a quick look at that during the break. But yeah, not fun. Whatever the hell was going on with them, it almost looks deliberate. Like somebody there's trying to tank it, and you know, go with the short sell and get the hell out. But
oh, for Southwest.
Maybe. I don't know. I've just never seen anything like it. Where the next, I mean, there were some other airlines canceling flights, but not even a tenth of what they were canceling. They're based out of Texas. So I don't know. It could have been the perfect storm, I suppose. Anywho, we're going to go to break here in just shortly. And then we're going to take phone calls as soon as we come back. Phone number is 848-222-2480. That's 848-222-2480. Nothing odd about that number. Although there is some numerology built into the number. Hopefully people remembered from when we first got this number, what it means. You remember, don't you, Karen?
Yes. Yeah. Wasn't it 2020? Something about it made 2020.
Supposed to let people think about it for a while. But yes, all the numbers add up to 2020. If you add them up, I can't remember which way. I have to look it up now. All right, so we're going to break. And when we come back, we'll take your phone call. So please, Colin, let's talk. It's the last show of the year. If anyone wants to do any predictions for 2023, I'm game. Why the hell not?
All righty.
All right. Karen, drop a beat.
Good times.
Are you a blue dot? Those questioning where we live are not just
here. What are you running instead of Truth Max?
I made a commercial for grounded extracts.
Of course this info is hidden from you. But
the hell is grounded extracts?
That no matter where you go,
it's
you aren't
this
alone.
Couple that they live over here by me now, but they make like herbal remedies and tinctures and stuff.
We are everywhere,
natural medicines.
And we are growing.
You know, drugs.
Find your
pharmaceutical company. They're evil.
They make drugs. But they're not like petroleum-based pharmaceutical drugs. They're, you know.
Brittany might fly out in 20 minutes, by the way. She's been stuck there for like 4 hours.
Only 4 hours?
She was it's a layover. She left Colorado Springs, landed in Denver to get on a plane, and she's been
Southwest.
4 hour overlay. I think so.
I'm serious.
You have her fly American. Let me find out.
Yeah, I was about to say, I'm amazed she's getting out through Southwest. I mean, they canceled everything. I mean, it was the lead headline on CNN all day.
I saw.
It's still.
They like 90% of the flights ever canceled were Southwest.
Yeah. Is
she's flying United.
Oh, yeah, that's why. Is Buttigieg, he's the governor of Texas, right?
No, he's the Department of Transportation.
Shout out to Karen B., Mark Sargent.
The little gay guy that's Department of Transportation that
flat Earth
doesn't do anything with the Department of Transportation.
Apparently, he's now throwing his hat in the ring.
For what? President again?
Uh-oh, my power's blinking. That's not good.
Hey,
if I drop, you're gonna have to like get the generator up and running.
Karen B.
Alrighty.
Every moon day in the early light.
Every moon day.
PM Eastern.
She'll just bring me in and we'll talk amongst ourselves.
For an early light chit chat.
Let me look.
Open phones, open topics, always chill.
I get a lot of rain.
There.
Green weather alerts. High wind.
Yes. Yes.
I got it. Welcome back to Strange World, Part 2, 4. It's you, me, and the always lovely Karen B. And yeah, you know what that was, Joe Jackson? Stepping out from his album.
Night and Day.
Yep. So we're taking your phone calls, and hopefully, because there's a high wind warning effect. If I drop off for some reason, it is not because the CIA came to get me, because I was criticizing them for their lazy writing in the Jack Ryan series. But the phone number to call in is 848-222-2480. That's 848-222-2480. Did I close that? Crap. One second.
I screwed up and I closed it.
The turbo bridge thing. Give me a second. I promise I will pick you guys up. Tonight would be a good night to call in, by the way.
Why, yes. 848-222-2480.
Yes, indeed, because it is the last show of the year.
Last show of the year, yes.
Next
year.
Just
your favorite moments of the past year. Biggest clown world moments of 2022.
Yeah. 2022, in my opinion, was a disappointment. There's so much potential. Not a lot happened. Everything, you know, there was a lot of bluster, a lot of talking, a lot of hype, and then no payoff. None. Come on. Give me something. Even a limited thing in Taiwan would have been better than nothing. We got nothing.
Who we start off with? We started off with the truckers protesting in Canada.
Right.
Remember when that was going on?
Yep. Truckers in Canada, Ukraine, which just kept fading and fading to where Zelensky apparently was just in D.C. Don't know how he got there. Don't know why he went. Don't even...
How ridiculous is it too? They're all standing there and they're putting up Ukrainian flags up next to American flags. Like, what is that BS?
Yeah. Yeah. Nobody cares.
I'm not a flag worshiper, but come on.
Yeah. No, nobody cares. Again, I am not picking on Americans, but the average American, even now, if you ask them, hey, do you know where Ukraine is? They'd have no idea. None. All right, let's go to, while this caller's talking, I'm going to pull up the high wind map just to make sure we're not going down out here. 505, you are on, you, me, and Karen B, last show of 2022. What's happening?
Mark, Karen, Tina. Hey, I wanted to talk about Artemis 2 tonight. And no, not Artemis 2, the space mission, but Artemis 2, surprisingly, is a mission of a surveillance plane that has recently been built by a defense contractor for the U.S. Army. Did you guys see that story?
I did not. Peanut, did you see the story about the Artemis 2 plane for the military? Why are they naming it? Why are they naming it Artemis?
Bingo.
Yeah, what's go ahead.
That's the whole point there, Mark. Yeah. When I looked up Artemis tonight just to see any news stories, that's the first story that came up, and it's actually called Artemis 2 as well. And it is, I got a few facts on it. It's called the Challenger 650's ability to fly long distances, altitudes over 40,000 feet. It has a 4,000 mile range, 10 hours of operational time. It's a surveillance plane built by a U.S. defense contractor for the Army, and it is part of the U.S. Army's high accuracy detection and exploitation systems, but that stands for Hades, H-A-D-E-S. Yes, colorful name. Another name for hell.
Wow.
So, this is getting biblical. We got Artemis, a fake god, and another expression here for Hades is actually the Greek for the Hebrew word of Sheol, which also is in the King James, always comes out to hell or the grave. Yeah. And pretty interesting. Why would they name it the same exact thing? That's what I'm wondering. Unless you wanted to promote basically your U.S. War propaganda, I guess.
That's right. Hey, that article, you don't have it up in front of you, do you? Or close by?
No, unfortunately I don't, but it's the first thing that came up. I'm sure if you, and I got it through my search engine I went through was Bing, but you know, if you just put Artemis in, it should pop right up.
All right.
The only other story was The only other story, that the second most popular story under that was going to be just the contractors to benefit financially. And there were just an article that this was a great opportunity because the actual space mission of Artemis was so successful. They were talking about all the great money for Boeing, Northrop Grumman.
Oh, yeah.
Aerojet, Lockheed Martin, you know, all the usual suspects as far as who's going to get the contracts for NASA for the future missions.
Yeah. Yeah. Artemis is a huge moneymaker. However, they're still going to run into an issue. Again, faking a probe when you launch in the middle of the night, an unmanned probe in the middle of the night, and let it run for 25 days and don't run any news stories on it. That's one thing. But the next, again, Artemis 2 won't, from what that NASA source said last week, isn't even going to, you know, it's supposed to launch in 2024. He goes, it's not going to even go until 25. So yeah, 3 years of funding, 3 years of money that can go around without any results whatsoever. Yeah, good for them. Well done. Another blanket you pulled over the heads of the American public.
Yeah, this goes well, ironically, what you were talking about earlier with the CIA. You know, this is just, wow, it's right in your face, what they're doing with this surveillance plane as well. And that surveillance plane, when you pull up a picture of it, doesn't really look like anything, like, too crazy. It just looks like a normal passenger plane, maybe some upturned wings. But they did have a picture of it. Interesting.
Boy, yeah, I'm looking at the same thing you are, and that does not look like much. That looks like, yeah. I've seen private planes better than that plane.
Pretty wimpy. I think I clicked on something else on this company's name. I was just trying to get what this whole Leidos means. They came up as, you know, I had never heard of them, but I couldn't really find much other than there were some other pictures of some cool stuff that they were putting out previously that looked pretty interesting, look kind of more like spaceships, some of their previous surveillance systems, I guess they're supplying the military. I like the Hades reference there.
Sure.
What do you think they're trying to tell?
I think their message is pretty clear. Anything else before I move on to the next one?
That's pretty much it.
Cool. Well, thank you for that.
The biggest, prediction I have is, let's see. What the heck? Jen from Dallas is going to have her own show.
That would be nice.
And, yeah. And hey, what the heck? I'm going to give you guys a Bible reference. I was looking up some Bible verses that had to do with Hades. And in the King James, Hades always comes out to hell. But yeah. I chose Matthew 11:23, and thou, Capernaum, which art exalted unto heaven, shall be brought down to hell. For if the mighty works which have been done in thee have been done in Sodom, it would have remained until this day. That's my Bible verse of the night and maybe of the year.
Thank you.
Last show.
Thank you. All right, man. Well, thanks. And, you know, we'll see you in 23.
Absolutely.
All right.
I love you guys, and everybody have a happy new year. And shout out to you, Karen, and Jan in Dallas.
All right. Have a good one. Let's jump down to, Texas, maybe. 281. It's you, me, Karen B. What's happening?
Man, what is the motherfucking dealio, man? Ron O'Neill.
Hey.
Northside. End of 22. Thank God this year was a piece of fucking shiznit, but I'm just chilling. How are y'all doing?
Good. Good. Right. Glad that this year's over. I'm hoping for at least more interesting things next year.
Fucking right, man. Your boy, I'm just bouncing like a bad check in this bitch, for real. Literally. And, you know, since the year 22 is almost over, I don't want to end the year on a bad note. So, with that said, it's about 17 motherfuckers that need to apologize to me. Yep. Awesome. About 17. Really, really. But no, I've just been chilling, listening to y'all, man. Listening to these conspiracies, you know, the fly shit in 2022. I don't know, these pedos getting exposed. Elon buying Twitter, pissing off the libs. Well, what else happened in 22? Man, geez, it's been a wild year. The most craziest shit, probably that Roe vs. Wade, you think?
Oh, you know, I had actually forgotten about that.
Yeah, that's right.
I
was like kind of a big epic, you know what I'm saying? People actually protesting and going to the judges' houses. That was kind of some crazy shit. Mm-hmm. Yep.
True.
Also, yeah. That's one thing. I wanted to tell you, Mark, that simulation stuff that you're talking about, like, are we living in a simulation? Maybe word's starting to get around. I mean, literally on the Dan Bongino show, like, last week, he had a show entitled, Are We Living in a Simulation? And, like, for the last 5 minutes, he really talked about it and how it's freaky. Yeah.
Right on. About time somebody else started talking about it.
Yeah, I know, right? You know, some people are talking about it, but, you know, with all the craziness going on, you know.
Yeah.
Taking hand or whatnot, though. But seriously, shit is crazy. But I ain't doing nothing, Dan. Just relaxing and, you know, just wanted to chime in to the last of the year or whatnot. Maybe I'll jump on the Zoom call with y'all later on, man, you know?
Right.
Shout out to, like, you and Cam B. Y'all keep doing your thing, man. Love to hear it, man. When's the next Flat Earth Clues about to drop? I haven't seen none in a minute.
Until I have a lot of people beating down my door asking for them, probably working on other things. Tomorrow I'm working on the narrative rant that I did at the beginning of the show. But
yeah, no, I heard the beginning of it. So if there's another part coming to it, okay, gotcha.
We'll see.
Yeah, the CIA, they're checking over everything. Yeah, they expose all of that shit. Love it.
Mm-hmm. Well, cool.
Man, well, you know, I ain't gonna hang around. I'll give you time for another call, man. Shout out to myself, of course. You can be Zulu, Master Gunner, you dig, man. And I'm gonna leave with a couple bar quotes, you dig. So,
okay.
You know, here go one. The fact that there's a highway to hell and only a stairway to heaven says a lot about anticipated traffic.
Nice.
And also, for y'all people out there, I use this, man, and it actually worked, man. How to write, I changed the light bulb on your resume. Single-handedly managed the deployment of a new environmental illumination system with zero cost overrun and no safety incidents.
Nice. Well done. Cool, man. Well, thank you. Thank you. And looking forward to talking to you. Talking to you as the new year rolls in.
Yeah, later on. Yeah, Zulu send me the link. I'll chime in or whatnot. So, man, I'll let y'all. Y'all be safe for that 2020. This is up I'm out this bitch.
Thank all you. Right, man. See ya. Have a good one. Do we have time for one more? Sure. You bet. Let's go to 646 out in Manhattan. What's happening out there, man?
Happy holidays.
Yeah.
You guys good?
Yeah. Yeah.
Fantastic.
It's been a minute. You know, the holidays makes everything last really long.
Sometimes. Does. You know? Yeah.
I feel like this holiday season is kind of just creeping by, and I'm okay with that.
Sure.
Yeah.
I'm okay with that, because I feel like time goes by too damn fast most of the time.
Oh man, I know that too. It's like sometimes then it's going to be like February before we know it. But I'm not going to mind that either, because this is my least favorite time of the year. But wasn't that crazy that like we found out that the CIA killed JFK, and that story lasted for like 24 hours?
Yeah, they basically admitted to killing JFK, and like nobody's talking about it.
No,
like no big deal.
The
it's kind of weird, right? It's like that should be the biggest story of.
I thought it would be a bigger deal really, too. It still kind of trips me out, the stuff that Tucker Carlson can say on his broadcast. Like, that shit would never fly.
That's 10 years ago. That's a really good point, actually. But also, like, because Fox is owned by the same people that own the rest of them.
Right.
So, like, there's one guy on there that can say whatever he wants. So they let him do that. And he says that. And apparently they're like, that's just their one little, you know, safety valve. on that network where, well, we'll just let him say whatever he wants, but then we'll come back around and smash the narrative by like shortening the story. So like, yeah, for 24 hours, you know, we found out who killed JFK, and then it was on to whatever the next story was. 24 right. hours, that's what we got.
Right. Yeah.
Merry Christmas.
And then the country froze over.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then there was a giant deep freeze. And that sucked, man. It was terrible. And I mean, like, New York City was just five, but there were some other places that were like in the negatives, like negative 10, you know, couldn't even go outside. You know, like, you try to go outside and smoke a cigarette and you're only half the cigarette's gone and you're like burning up from the cold. So there you go.
One could run an anti-smoking campaign based on that.
I know. How's everything else? You guys good?
Yeah. No real complaints. Again, other than, you know, the storyline, I'm just not a fan of it. I think everything's happening out there is really lazy to the point where there's no news. Even the news people that crave the, you know, crave producing the news, they don't have anything to produce right now. So,
you know, and you're just frustrated because you don't have any news bits to like.
I got nothing. Thank God for the CIA this week.
Damn it.
Next week. I mean, how many times do I get to say that? God bless you, CIA.
Other parts of the world right now. USA, stuff's going on in Europe and stuff right now. The USA is kind of...
That's true. Although the USA isn't covering it. Like you were talking about the Paris, the riots
right,
in Paris.
Riots in Paris.
Isn't
right
Paris
now,
like yeah. a dump? It's a dumpster fire over there right now, right?
Oh,
like
huge. Yeah, like it's being done. Destroyed. There's like all these Kurdish people protesting in Paris, and it's crazy over there right now.
I'm a little surprised nobody's covering that.
Yeah, and no news about that, no. Of course.
Mm-mm.
No.
No news about anything that we want to hear about.
No.
I don't know. I have a prediction. I predict that you guys will be on the air in December 2023. Pretty much 100% payback on that one.
Really? Are you just going to throw out that dare to the agency right now? Because there's a guy, there's like three or four guys sitting in an office going, oh, we could take that wager. But that's all right.
Anyway, I just like call and say hi. I hope you guys are good.
Thanks. All right, man.
Anyway, I'll talk to you later. That's it.
All right. Have a good one.
Later.
See ya.
Okay, bye.
Bye. Well, we still got a few minutes until the break. And our phone lines right now are open. I picked up everybody I could pick up at the moment. So, should we bring in Master Gunner, Brian Burton, to fill out the segment? Yeah, sure. Why not? Let's see if we can find him. One second. He's always on call. Master I'm Gunner, hiding. Are you there? You are there.
I am hiding.
Why are you hiding?
Because there's nothing in the world.
Nothing happening. I know. And you look probably more than I do. Although I was a little disappointed that you, being a military man, had not even gotten into the Tom Clancy series.
I watched the first season. The only problem I have is transitioning the main guy from The Office to...
Oh, right. I forgot to tell people that. So there have been five Jack Ryans. Alec Baldwin for one, Harrison Ford for two, Chris Pine, which the totally forgettable, not written by Tom Clancy movie, and then
Ben Affleck.
No. Oh yeah, sorry, Ben Affleck, and for one, and Krasinski. What's his first name? Crap, Jake.
John
Krasinski.
Yeah.
The
guy from The Office.
Jim, yeah, he's done some comedy, but he's tall, good-looking guy. But
he's the guy in the center, the main in the thumb.
Yeah, he's the guy.
Yeah, he looks like the guy from The Office.
Yeah,
he is the guy from The Office.
He is the guy from The Office.
That's so weird that the dude that from The Office is now like.
Yeah, he was also the guy that played Shazam, Captain the Captain Marvel in the DC universe. He was
so he was already an actor.
He's also Mr. Fantastic in that Marvel movie.
Okay, so he's already been in action movie.
Yeah. No idea. He's done action. He's done action films, and again, there's nothing wrong with him.
He's a good actor. It's just transition sometimes.
Yeah, and what they did was is that again, when you own an IP, when you own an intellectual property, outright, you can do anything you want, and so you can just say, oh yeah, Jack Ryan's in this, and we're gonna build the story around him, completely new. Because we own Jack Ryan, we own the character. No different than when George Lucas sold Star Wars to Disney for $4 billion, and then he had no control over it anymore. They could do any. They could introduce wokeness, for example. Not that they would.
Come on.
But you could, but literally, you could do anything you want. So what they did was because the movies have been somewhat dated. I mean, come on, Hunt for October was 1990. They just retreaded everything. And to where, I'll give you a spoiler, Brian, where literally the last episode in season 3 was, it might as well have been the last 90 minutes of Hunt for October. They stole the scenes, the dialogue, the whole premise. It was straight out of that. It's like, really? Just throw
that
in there?
That's because Hollywood can't do any freaking thing new.
No, they can't.
That's why they're doing Twister 2 and another Terminator,
another Rambo. Yeah, all that stuff.
Hey, Avatar evidently
make everything.
Hey, what?
Avatar 2 is evidently bombing.
Yeah, yeah. I watched.
I heard. What a disappointment.
they didn't hire the proper blue people.
I watched the Critical Drinkers review, and he had the same premise that I did, which was, look, it's been 13 years. I understand why he didn't make it for as long as he did, because he was so pissed off that he didn't win Best Picture. He lost to The Hurt Locker. He lost to his ex-wife. I get that. But why even bother? Why? What do you have to prove at this point? As a matter of fact, you're going to break your streak, because up until now, he has never lost money on a movie. Never. Nope. He has always made money, going all the way back before True Lies, all the way back to The Abyss. He made money. 13 years later. Oh no, I'm gonna. It's almost like they fed his ego, and when he came out and says, oh yeah, by the way, it's gonna have to make $2 billion for me to break even. It's like, dude, you are setting the bar way too high.
I think, and I could be wrong, this is just a guess, so yeah. Don't hold to it. I think the only movie that was actually really successful this year, would have been The Maverick.
It was Top Gun. It was the most profitable movie of the year,
and it was the least woke.
It was the least woke. Yeah. No, where he went wrong is that, like with anyone, with the writing, and we'll go to break here in just a minute, which is, so the first one, if you remember back 13 years ago, Avatar was basically Dances with Wolves in space. He just stole Dances with Wolves, which of course was also a ripoff of other things, Going Native, the classic story of Going Native.
Mm-hmm.
And he applied to space. Well, this one, he had no premise else to go off of. So from what I understood, they inserted like 90 minutes of a teen movie into the middle of this thing, where they were focusing so much on the family of the two main characters and then the trials of these of the young blue kids, that by the one reviewer I follow, he says, because by the time I that 90 minutes was over, you've forgotten what the hell you were watching. You're like, oh wait, oh, we're back into this Earth versus the blue people thing. I thought we were watching a teen drama. And yeah, and of course, because it was him, they let him run 3 hours. Not the extended version, the standard version is 3 hours.
Before you go to break, I just like saying, you think you would have learned his lesson from Lucas.
Yes.
When he brought the prequel to bed.
Yep. You would think you would learn. I don't know how they talked him into it. Don't know why. Maybe he could not lose. Maybe he's like, look, just freaking direct it. Help us.
$2 billion. I don't know.
I don't think he put up any of his own money. I hope he didn't put up any of his own money. I hear it's gorgeous.
$2 billion?
Well, no. He's saying there's enough that went into this from all parties that the only way this movie was going to make money. And he might have been exaggerating, but maybe not. I don't know.
Whatever.
But the point was, I'm not going to go see it in the theater. I mean, plus he couldn't have asked for the worst possible time. Pandemic just tore the theaters to shreds. Nobody's going to theaters anymore.
For future movie writers, having beautiful scenes in a movie is no good without a story.
There you go.
I.e. Rings of Power.
Yes.
Beautiful, beautiful scenery in that show.
Yep. Terrible writing.
I have no idea what the hell the show is actually about. But beautiful scenery.
Yeah. I mean, you would have been better off going a little cheaper and doing Avatar streaming and making it a big, big deal for streaming. Because graphics, you know, the graphics back then were absolutely revolutionary. Same graphics now? Nope.
Yep.
Nope. Not when people are used to sitting on their couch with Netflix and a bag of Cheetos. Right. A big bag of Cheetos.
That gives you COVID.
Yeah, exactly. All right. We are going to our break. And when we come back, we're going to take some phone calls. Please do call in when you come back. 848-222-2480. It's the last chance to talk to us before the year ends and before the CIA comes and gets me and says, how dare you criticize our writing? It's like, come on, make better shows. If you're going to take over a show, that's one thing. I expect that. Hire better writers. Hire me.
They don't care to try anymore.
I should do the Joe Rogan pitch. It's like, look, if you want me to write some of your stuff, go ahead.
No, because you everything you write makes everybody hungry.
Good point. All right, we will come back from the break. So, Karen, let's go to that special break music.
Support local flat earthers. Grounded extracts. Like a plug into an outlet, nature is a key into the mind. Once there, it can clean out old chemical leftovers and nourish the mind and body. Life is regained. The road becomes joyful as clarity and self-awareness return. Herbs, roots, algae, and fungi have helped many of us heal, move closer to our goals, and gain control of true priorities over carnal desires. Join us in leaving the chemical, material world and enter into the natural realm, from farm to farm. These finest creations are handmade and are more potent than anything your corner co-op has to offer. Our products, excluding our tinctures, are made to order to assure freshness and maximum effectiveness, fusing together healing herbs with tasty counterparts to bring out full potentials. There is so much joy in working with the natural world given to us by our Creator. Let's take part.
Thank you. sneaks, tip up the beak, I'm a 33.
Welcome back to Strange World Part 3 of Forts, you, me, and the always wonderful Karen B. And by the way, had a listener, show listener, correct me. And he is absolutely right. And I'm going to throw this in Skype chat. I've also thrown it in the other chat, which is, I'll throw it in Funky Bunch. Is that John Krasinski, who plays Jack Ryan, is not the same guy that played Shazam. However, in my defense, that was played by Zachary Levi. When you look at these two guys at a glance, I swore they were the same person. I've been watching these two guys in separate shows, and yeah, they look slightly different, but they look so damn similar. You look at the comparison here between these two?
I don't know. They don't look that much alike to me.
Are you saying all white guys look alike? Is that
no,
what you're
I'm not saying that. I'm saying that their coloring, the beard, the bone structure, they look very, very similar. So my apologies. Zachary Levi was Shazam, and John was Jack Ryan. So there you go. Anyway, and in fact, sorry, the correction also is that the John Krasinski was also Mr. Fantastic in Doctor Strange 2. Mr. Fantastic.
Not out of touch.
From the Fantastic Four. So there you go.
I've not seen most of those movies, nor do I.
That's right. All right. Well, back to the boards. And let us grab a couple calls. Oh boy. Let's go to Phoenix first, potentially. 602, it's you, me, Karen B. What's happening?
Hey there. So real quick thing about you're talking about Jack Ryan.
Yeah.
The guy who Jack Ryan is based off of is Dr. Steve Pachanik, who is a CIA agent. He also overthrows governments and things like that. He's also the guy that told Alex Jones that no one died at Sandy Hook, and also told Alex Jones that Trump marked all of the ballots with invisible ink. And he's still a president and things like that. So it's just interesting tying the whole thing into the CIA and whole nonsense with nuclear war that they keep claiming is going to be happening soon with Russia.
Yeah.
Which, you know,
oh, yeah.
At best.
Yeah. Again, people forget that the entire Jack Ryan series, seriously, going all the way back, because he wrote Hunt for October all the way back in 1984, sold it for $5,000, the initial sale, which was cheap, but then he got money on the back end with the movie stuff. Was, you know, again, about the CIA is this, you know, stand up white hat group that all they do is stop bad things from happening in the world. And, you know, being, you know, they introduced that so slowly, you know, over a series of decades, there are people like, oh yeah, CIA, they're the good guys. It's like, yeah, it depends on which way you're looking at it. Or so you say CIA in other countries, you'll get some completely different looks. Trust me.
Yeah, going back to COVID, Steve Pachanik was on Alex Jones's show talking about how good Tony Fauci was and how he's a good guy to lead the whole COVID thing. So, I mean, that's the whole thing of it all sort of, you know, ties in. It's all very laughable.
Yeah. Anything else?
No, that was it. Just thank you guys. And whatever happened to Dottie? Why doesn't she call in anymore?
I do not know off the top of my head what Dottie's doing. I'm sure she's well, though. You know, we had called.
Dottie got a new boyfriend.
There you go. She's probably got a new beau. And think about this. Like, Belarus, she hasn't called in for a while. Could be because, you know, she's from Belarus. Hard to say. But we have callers come and go.
Well, if Dottie is out there, we miss you.
Well, thanks. That's great. All right, man. Any shout outs? Or was Dottie your big shout out?
Keep it up. Good show.
Well, thank you. Thank you. All right. Well, have a good one, and we'll see you on the other side of the year.
Indeed.
All right. Have a good one. See you, bye.
Happy New Year.
Yep. By the way, the current weather report for me, it's not good. The winds are. I'm looking at the power company's outage map. Right now, everything Seattle and south is getting hit pretty good. Right, we're in okay shape so far. Crossing my fingers. But if I freeze up, if I do one of these things, you know, I don't move, and then Karen laughs. It's like, did we lose Mark? And then she takes over, and then you never see me again. That's because a tree went down somewhere and hit a power line. But we'll work on that. Okay. So, Turbo Bridge, let's go to New York, potentially. 845, what's happening out there?
Hey, Mark, what's going on?
Hey,
I just got to say, screw Hollywood. You know, Sean Penn just came out this week and said that anybody that's unvaxxed should not have a job. You know, I'm so tired of these communist dirtbags telling me what I can and can't do, because I don't want to take the kill shot that Pfizer wants to stick in me. So screw Hollywood. Screw them all. You know, they need to repent, because Jesus Christ is coming back one of these days, and he's going to crush them into powder, and then they're going to blow away like chaff in the wind. You know, Jesus isn't a little baby anymore in a manger. He's the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. His eyes are flaming like fire. He's shining like the countenance of the sun. And he's got a sword coming out of his mouth, and with it, he's going to destroy all of his enemies. So they better shut their mouths and repent before it's too late. That's all I wanted to say. I'm just so tired of these communist Hollywood bastards, you know, coming out, spouting off their mouths. Shut up and make movies. You know, that's all I got to say.
All right. Well, thank you for that.
I'd like to, Yeah. I don't know if you saw that, but Sean Haspen has come out and basically said anybody that doesn't have the vaccine should not work. How dare you? How dare you not take that kill shot? You know, it's disgusting.
Yeah.
Disgusting. No, he's, you know, everybody has the right to do what they want, I thought, in America.
He's,
you know, who is he? You know, and yep. I used to like that guy. I used to like him. I used to like his movies. I thought he was a good actor. Now I can't stand him.
11-11.
All right. Well, thank you. Thank you. And by the way, is this your first time calling in?
No. This is Ray Romano's brother.
I know you.
I don't know if you remember that. Yeah, Ray Romano's brother.
Yeah.
I just had, I've been thinking about that all night. I was just like, you know what? I'd like to make a list of all these communist, you know, Hollywood CIA agents that make movies. Then all sit there and spout this crap off. I'd like to make a list. And any one of them that said anything or done anything, we should just boycott all their movies. Like, I don't know why people keep watching their crap when all they want to do is kill us.
Yeah. Well, you know? there are a lot of sheep out there. So.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah, I'm boycotting them. You know, I haven't listened to a Celine Dion song since she said that all children should be like one gender and we should not. Yeah, I haven't listened to one of her songs. The woman made me want to puke when she said that. She put out that commercial. Did you see that commercial?
I did.
Where she, you know, she blended the genders and everything turned black and there's no more pink and blue. It's all just black and we all need to wear black now because, you know, and all the babies just need to decide for themselves what gender they're. It's just disgusting, man. These people are destroyers and they're destroying society and we worship them like they're some sort of freaking heroes. And they're not. They're destroyers. They're high paid. Beautiful destroyers. You know, they look good on the outside, but inside they're full of disgusting death. That's all they are.
All right.
So I hope people will wake up and realize that, you know?
All right. Well, again, thank you. Thank you very much. And got to let you go because we got calls we got to get to. And plus, you're not going to stop on your rant. I know it. The energy's with him. And he wants to take them all down, which is great. Wonderful. Good. All right, we're going to 857, who is doing the meetup in a couple weeks out in Oklahoma. What's happening out there?
Okay, testing, 1, 2, 3. We're live from U.S. Highway 169 in Garnet, Kansas, heading southbound back to Oklahoma. Anyway, I don't know, Mark, if you heard about this one, or Karen. In my hometown of Hingham, Massachusetts, roughly a month ago or just over a month ago, there was a fatal crash in an Apple store. An SUV blasted through the store. Unfortunately, one person, or according to the official story, one person was killed and 16 were injured. And I dug into the story a little bit, and who knows, I mean, it could be coincidence, but I noticed the last two digits of the license plate on the SUV that went in there was 33, and along with one of the fire rescue vehicles had a 33 in the license plate. And a lot of people said 33 can mean hoax. So who knows? I mean, it could be coincidence, but I found that interesting.
I do remember a little bit of the story, but not much. It wasn't on the radar very long.
I mean, the New York Times picked it up. A lot of the, you know, big news networks. It wasn't just the local news. But, I mean, again, who knows? I mean, it could be coincidence, but just something I, you know, did notice. Another thing, anyway, I talked about this on Karen's show yesterday. I was curious your opinion, Mark. I've been running into some locations here and there that are flat out refusing to take cash. For example, a car wash a number of months ago in Meridian, Mississippi, and also a local coffee shop, actually, in Tulsa. Now, I thought that on a $100 bill or a $10 bill or whatever, you know, it says this is legal tender for all debts, public and private. Are they breaking the law and just, you know, that people don't realize this, or no, can they get away with it?
No, they can get away with it. You can, your business, because it's your business. I mean, you can, there are some businesses that don't accept American Express, and there's some businesses that, you know, nobody, you know, uses the Diners Club anymore and crap like that. If somebody doesn't want to use cash for whatever reason, and plus there's lots of businesses that temporarily don't use cash if something breaks, or they only go to cash when something breaks. So I wouldn't, again, people have asked me this for a number of years now. I am not necessarily concerned because cash is still king out there, especially in the secondary markets. And they're outside of the major cities, cash is the way to go. I mean, there is entire industries that would die if cash wasn't allowed. So even the younger generation growing up, there's a whole, you know, and under the age of 30, a lot of them aren't carrying cash. That is true. But yeah, it's going to take more time and more effort if you're going to try to push that narrative. Let me throw one more thing in the mix, which is, if you can't, especially in America, if you can't even get the anti-gun thing rolling with any momentum, how the hell are you supposed to do cash? And remember, the gun thing should be easy, right? Because there's two sides to that coin. But cash, who's going to back it? Who's going to step forward and say, you know, whose vested interest in the general public is it? They're going to come out. It's like, oh yeah, no cash. That's the way to go. Why? How? How's that going to work?
They
how are you going to pay strippers?
Hey Mark, they stopped using cash. A lot of stores will stop using cash so they don't get robbed.
Of course, there is a crime deterrent thing to cash. But there's also a pro-crime thing. Come on, almost all crime runs on cash. And those industries have a long reach. They lobby the hell out of people. No, I don't see it. Sorry, there'll be some isolated things here and there, but nah, I'm not worried. Not yet. Anything else?
Good to know. Yeah. So anyway, let's see, shout outs. And I have to make an apology, and I realized this yesterday, about 5 minutes. I was like, you know, my tongue just slipped up. My brain accidentally confused Grabsky with Rick Humber, and I accidentally said shout out to the late Rick Humber, and I meant to say the late Grabsky. So my apologies on Karen's show. I can't believe it came out that way.
No, don't. It's okay.
I never met Rick. Oh my God! If it came out again, my brain messed up. I never met Rob Schema. Rick Hummer was actually the first person that I met in the community, actually, September 2020.
Yeah. Oh no. There were moments when I was spending some time in a hotel with him for a week that I wanted him dead, but he's not dead. He's absolutely alive. When he stayed up late, you'd think something bad would happen to him on his way back to the hotel. Nope, nothing bad ever happened. Not even a broken finger. Nope. really, really great. Anyway, anything else before before I let you go?
So, shout out to Forrest, the late ref, Steve, Rick Hummer, Ian Mark, Karen, Sue Pinelli, Jake and Dan from the band, John from New Mexico. Let's see, we love Brittany, Truth or Chloe, and everyone, Brian Steven, and everyone else that I cannot think of at this split second as I cruise along live on 169 South in Kansas, heading back to Oklahoma.
All right. All right, well, have a good one, man. We'll talk in 23.
Sounds good.
All right, see ya. All right, let's go to... Oh, Peanut, where should I... Oh, okay. No. Let's do Texas. Do we do that one? 469, have I talked to you tonight?
Hello.
Hi.
How are you guys?
Good.
Great. What's
yeah, that? This is my first time. Yeah, my first time joining you guys. I saw on my recommendations, so I was like, let me check you all out. So I just wanted to say, I was looking at another podcast, and they were speaking about the AI generated type of technologies and how it's being used, for example, in the criminal field, and he was explaining how you don't need to be arrested or, you know, incarcerated or anything like that, you know, to have your, you know, picture pulled up any third party apps or websites that has your picture on it, you know, can just be sent to the system and an agency, you know, can go to it. So, you know, what are your thoughts, you know, on that?
Well,
type of topic.
I'm not going to speak for Karen, but it is one of the good and bad things about social media, in that people are so voluntarily putting out an unbelievable amount of images and information about themselves out there, which is available to anyone. Mm-hmm. So beforehand, when law enforcement couldn't find somebody because, you know, all they had was a name, now it's like, yeah, but, you know, freaking put their name to the system. And I'll even take that out of the criminal sector for a second, which is the other side is the resume system. So when people get a resume from somebody, a lot of times they don't even read the resume. They just look their name, punch it up, see if the address and the location sort of map, and they look, go through the social media contacts. So it's what was the line that I heard a couple of years ago, which was, if Nazi Germany had the ability to look in the future and see what we did now, there'd be this line, be like, wait, you got people to volunteer all their information? I mean, we're doing it and we're treating it like a recreational sport. We're treating it like fun, like entertainment. It's like, oh, look, you know, like a competition.
Yep.
So, you know, is it bad? Law enforcement looks up. It's like, why would it be bad? We're the ones doing it. We're the ones volunteering. You're asking them not to look and use it to their advantage.
He was also saying that, you know, for example, he was like, you know, if they have a case, you know, and the AI generator thing goes through multiple faces, you know, your face could possibly pop up, even though you may not have did something. And he said, you know, you better have a good ass alibi.
It's possible. Sure. Why not? I mean, no. And when you say AI, of course, you're talking about a broad spectrum of things, but if face recognition software does it have the chance to make mistakes? You bet. Absolutely. And do people make mistakes on top of it? Sure. Does that mean that we could enter that future scenario where people are accused of stuff that they weren't? Yeah, it's possible. Although, again, the chances of you being, remember, because the information also has to cross index. So is it possible that you live next to somebody and you look really, really close to them and your addresses are almost the same and your background stories are the same? That's pretty remote. But could it happen? Yeah, it's possible. One in a million type scenarios. I I don't know. It's just the system we've built so far. You're talking to probably talking to the wrong guy when it comes to this, because I was a big believer in at one point in internet registration. So anyway, the internet's got some wonderful things to it, and it's got a lot of dark things to it, and a lot of potential for corruption to it as well. Law enforcement, though, okay. I don't know. I wouldn't be worried about local law enforcement. You got to remember also, sorry, let's go off on a quick tangent here before the break, which is got to remember who built the internet. The internet was built from a military backbone system. Initially started out as the backup systems in case, you know, all the lines, everything was cut. And then it turned into a bulletin board system. And then finally the public got a hold of it. So you're asking intelligence networks to not look at it. Of course, they're going to look at it. They've had access to MySpace and Facebook.
They're gonna look.
So just don't.
They're gonna look.
My advice to anyone out there, if you're going to commit crimes, don't brag about it online in any format. Right? don't do it. Anything as simple as, look, I'm going to steal this.
Post it online and say you did it. Yep.
Yeah. Don't. I mean, even it's as, you know, don't do flash mob robs or flash robs. You know, don't say you're in the getaway car. You know, don't even hit somebody and film it. Don't do it. It's because everything goes out there. The movie line, everything on the internet sticks. So don't do it. There you go.
You guys remember when the DoorDash thing had a glitch and everybody was everybody was getting food or something like that, free food.
Right.
And then like a few days later, you know, they had, you know, the money taken out their bank's account, and they're, you know, boasting about it online. And it was like, you know, you're kind of stupid for doing that, but they were going to find you anyways because your bank account.
Possibly. Sure.
The DoorDash.
Or the bank or the armored car that dropped one of its bags in the highway. Remember down in Southern California? And all the kids, all the kids were filming themselves picking up money and filming themselves reacting to other people picking up money. It's like, just pick up the money, turn off the phone. It's
leave.
Get out of there, man.
Everybody just wants attention.
Yeah. Anyway, anything else before we let you go?
Oh yes, I have another one. So I'm pretty sure you guys paid attention to, you know, the Green Ranger pass recently. You know, we just had like a plethora of all these quote unquote celebrities just conveniently passing away and stuff. And it's just like, you know, the cryptocurrency guys, they, I saw some articles about that. I think it was two of them.
Yeah.
One apparently passed away in his sleep. And it's like, I don't know, you know, I know BS when I see it.
Yes. Let me address both of them really quick, because then we got to go to break, I swear. And Peanut Gallery just said me, yeah, goodbye Green Ranger. The B and C list celebrities, everything there has to do with something that is called safe and effective. That's all it is, which is why A-listers are not going down. Yes, Celine is not going to tour anymore, and Justin Bieber is going to have a tick for probably a long time, and Katy Perry also have a tick. That's the safe and effective. As far as the crypto things, look into when you get some time where crypto started. There are, you know, there's too much of a temptation for people that control the money there. Look, money does weird things to people. And if all of a sudden somebody that controls the servers all of a sudden realizes, like, dude, I could totally make a break for it with this money, bad things can happen.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, nefarious types sometimes get involved when big unregulated money is there. All right, hey, we gotta let you go, but thank you for calling in. How is this first time?
I had a good time. Thank you. I subscribed and everything. I'll be back next time, maybe. Thank you.
Thank you.
Awesome. All right, and she hung up. I didn't even get a chance to.
She said it was in her recommended. Can you believe that?
Wow. That's impressive.
Bust through the algorithms on YouTube and get a new.
Well, you know, I got that channel taken away. The you know, that channel was showing up number one on the search engines. The FE channel that hadn't been posting for 4 years, And it
really?
Was, yeah, yeah. I made a couple calls and
shut up.
That's what David thinks I did. David's like, who did you talk to?
Why did it go away?
Yeah, it's gone.
I wonder what happened.
Yeah, they were listening to us. What was happening? They
knew probably. It was, yeah, that's they, probably what it is. More likely than anything, they were listening to
yeah,
us.
Yeah, yeah. It's like, who changed the algorithm? Why is that thing on top? They're complaining about it.
Watch, probably we're going to get squashed again. Now they're like, they got a new viewer. How'd they get in so open? Someone's recommended.
I know. My sub count has been crawling. Well, I don't know. I should take bets and see if David hits 100K by the end of 23, because his is crawling too. And it's like, oh, man. Anyway. All right. We're going to our final break. And when we come back, we will take your phone calls. I swear I will pick up 504-215. Possibly 985, 904, and anyone else we can get to. So, Karen, the outro, please.
All righty.
Where is the
on property approaching food trailer.
Engage Delta 9.
Roger.
Hey, I know you.
Shh, they might be listening.
CIA?
Maybe.
Aliens?
Probably.
Globalists?
Definitely. I may have already said too much.
We have what you need.
Really?
It's flat.
I'm listening.
And round.
Go on.
And delicious.
Tell me the secret. Tomorrow.
We move around quite a bit.
Ah, a mobile command center. A strong strategy. I like where your head's at.
Anything else?
I was never here.
Long live Flat Earth.
Long live Flat Earth.
Make it all away.
Welcome back to Strange World, part 4 of 4. It's you, me, and the always wonderful Karen B. We're taking phone calls. It's 848-222-2480. That's 848-222-2480. As I'm checking my power map, can I make it through the last 30 minutes of the show without going dark? It's possible. We'll see. We're going to be optimistic. Phone number is 848-222-2480. Okay, let's start with Florida. 904, you're on. Dazzle us, won't you?
Hello, Dan. My music journey. How are you doing?
Good. What's going on?
Well, just calling in on the last week of the year, so I thought we had some great callers already. So I wanted to do that final vote on the stories of 2022, so I'm going to throw mine out there quickly. I'm going to say that it caps off with Zelensky, because this guy, you know, is some kind of a, you know, comedian clown actor that they placed in a puppet dictatorship role over the, you know, alleged country of Ukraine, which was really always part of many other countries and over hundreds of years has been in dispute or, you know, ruled. Basically, they're brother and sisters of Russians, but now they've tried to make it into a NATO country.
Right.
But to put him in front of the, as you said last week when we were hanging up, to take this guy in his military green suit, he's not in a suit and tie, or any kind of appropriate clothing for that type of an audience, at least, even though I'm not really into that suit and tie stuff either. I got invited to the DeSantis inauguration on next Tuesday, and I'm not going, but not that I don't like him, but anyhow, it's a suit and tie thing. And he's wearing a military outfit in front of everybody and giving a kiss to Pelosi and putting up an Ukrainian flag. To me, that's the symbol of 2022 right there. It might not be the story that affects the most people directly, like the depopulation agenda, but the fact that we put that clown in front of our whole government telegraphs to the whole world that we're a total clown show and that we jumped the shark, because you can't put up a flag of another country in front of supposedly the, you know, the world power and pretend that, especially with this, with type of a clown comedian actor that we did it with, that you can claim that we're really a relevant power anymore.
All right. Cool.
And then, but I will say, of course, depopulation is right up there. People don't know about it, but the Club of Rome and the rest of them with the, I don't know if you know Sasha Ladipova and Catherine Watt on their investigations, but now they're tracing it all back to DARPA. You had that earlier caller that seems to know about a lot of military stuff, and
yeah,
I know Brian does, but basically this has all been run out of our own, you know, military and the orange guys, Operation Warp Speed. And so you can't put all the blame on the Biden regime or anybody. It's obviously people up above.
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
Yeah. And then finally, the FTX thing exposes, and I, you know, I'm a little bit, you know, I got hit by that, by the way, but not, I didn't have any money in FTX, but I had a little money in something else. And, my accounts got frozen. Anyway, it pointed out the height of corruption, that you can have this back circle jerk where they're funding all these Democrat people that are voting to give Ukraine money and then floating all the money back to their elections in the fake elections that we have.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
I'll leave it there. That was my rant. I'm sorry I'm not more funny tonight, but
it's okay.
On another channel. She's always over there. You know, she's got a crush on Eric DeBay now, so that's why we never hear from her anymore. That's her new would-be boyfriend.
Really?
I'm just kidding. Lots of love to Dottie. That was just a joke.
Wow. All right. Any shout-outs? for the last
three people go into a bar: the priest, a rabbi, and a lawyer. Only one comes out. No, shout outs to all you guys. Happy New Year, 2023.
Have a good one, man. Talk soon.
All right, good to hear you.
It reminds me of that little Stephen Wright joke, where it's I broke a mirror, I'm supposed to get 7 years. Bad luck. My lawyer thinks he can get me 5. All right. We can time this. All right, let's grab Jan. 214. Hi Jan. What's happening?
I had a birthday.
Are you supposed Happy to admit birthday. To that? Or you're not going to tell us what birthday? You're just saying you had a birthday.
Yes, last week I had a birthday, and I'm almost as old as you, Mark. but that would be a lie, and I try not to do that, except for special occasions. Hello to you, Mark, Karen, and Peanut.
So, hi, Jan. Hi.
Is that you, Mark?
That is me. I'm saying
you're saying
hi.
Lie to me again? Oh. I got that Dottie joke from Dan.
Did you?
And Does he sing?
Dan? Yes, he does.
Well, if he sounds like Matt Monroe, I love him.
See, I don't know who that is.
Only he would know that.
All right. Hopefully he'll figure that one out and let us know next year.
You don't know who that is?
Matt Monroe?
Mm-hmm.
Peanut,
oh, that's
punch
okay.
up Matt Monroe for me.
Oh no! Oh,
I don't know who Matt Monroe. What era is he from?
Oh, back in the day.
Oh yeah, I'm looking. Okay, if most of his photographs are black and white, then no, I don't know. Yes, here's a shot of Matt in 1965. He was born.
Oh wow.
1930 in London. Now I'm going to, you know what? After I'm done with the show tonight, I'm going to punch up a couple of his songs and I'm going to listen to him. The Man with the Golden Voice.
Oh, yes.
Portrait of My Love.
Well, you've got
my
a girl,
kind of girl
with you, to make it really nice.
Yesterday. Oh, he was the original one that sung Yesterday. Oh, no. He did a cover of the Beatles Yesterday.
Yeah, that's the only, only rendition of Yesterday that I can stand is the one that he does. But
I will say this, he's good enough that he actually did one of the intro songs for a Bond film, from Russia with Love.
Oh
my God, yes, and I do know. He sung Born Free. Wow.
Yeah,
he's got a great voice. I know this guy.
And he's very romantic. He's very romantic. It's kind of sad about Dallas. I think it's kind of spooky based on not covering President Kennedy's murder here.
Yeah.
CIA, et cetera.
Sure.
And Southwest Airlines is just down the street from me. It started out in the 70s, and the original owners have been gone about 15 or so years. And that's really kind of spooky because I don't think it's pilot sickness, but I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. It almost seems like the scheduling was done deliberately to where the pilots were not available, and combine it with the freeze. I don't know, but Southwest is going to be, it's different from what was back in the day because social media amplifies things so much. So if thousands and thousands and thousands of people not only couldn't get on their flights, but they couldn't get through the tech support and ended up having to fly another airline just to get out, that's going to multiply. You know how that goes with the rumor mill. People are being like, yeah, dude, don't fly Southwest. So yeah, we'll see what happens to these guys. I mean, the stock price actually is only down a couple bucks, surprisingly, but maybe people thought it was tanking a couple days ago and the price kept it afloat. Who knows?
It's kind of really spooky, and amen to what Dan said too about Ukraine and things. And it goes so deep that many people do not know yet, but I believe they will.
Right.
And I think I still will stand that God has had enough and will be, I think he wants everyone's cards laying face up. And that's certainly, you know, happening. And I hope you get to the snow okay, because you're such a trooper, and your family and everything, and Karen and her children, and Peanut and his children. And I would like to say hello to John and William, and to all the Flat Earth people in Canada, and regular people in Canada too. Their country has been so taken over. We're not quite as bad as that. And I won't say yet, because I believe things will change soon. And I wanted to say hello to January 6th, to USM, and For Justice and Complete Restoration, and to Miss Belarus and her countrymen. They certainly have been in the news for the good, which is wonderful. So,
well, thank you, Jen.
That was it. Thank you.
Thank
Very
you.
Nice. And I hope to speak with you several times next year.
Yeah, Dallas has really got a lot of calls from this area tonight.
Yeah.
Of course, it's fun. Yeah. So anyway, thank you.
All right. You have a good night, Jan.
Thank you, Jan.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye, Karen.
You know, she mentioned, you know, you had kids and Peanut had kids, and it's like, I have kids, but they're paid for with cash. It's different, I suppose. In fact, I'm up for a bid for that baby you mentioned earlier.
The Whitsitt baby?
Yeah, the Whitsitt baby. I'm in there. I'm in the top 10 right now in bids. It's not a silent auction.
That's a very valuable pure blood flat earth baby.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Should go for top dollar. All right. Bid early, bid often. How much time do we got? We'll take one more call before 845. Let's do, you know what? Heck with it. Let's go for broke. Dennis, I'll give you a few minutes. What's happening? Where are you driving?
Rather Interstate 205 in Oregon, as usual. The weather's not too bad compared to what this had last week. So I guess it's the same with you.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, now where are you headed?
I'll get to it. If I could, if I got enough time, three things to say. But first,
go ahead.
Shout out to Dan and also to Susan Borjo. Within the past week, Dan, he received the Christmas present I sent to him, which was a learner sextant, like a plastic training sextant. So I got the same one myself. So that project I mentioned earlier in the year about measuring the distance to the sun, that's over the long term, that's coming along. We just, each of us got to get the time to get familiar. But sometime in 2023, I do plan to visit Chris and Liz Bailey over there in Ohio, you know, the organizers of the Take on the World conference, and Jeff, talk about old times. I sat with them at the Dallas conference, but that just happens to be, there's a point on Lake Erie near them that's a little bit more than, little, just over 800 miles due north of Mayport Naval Station, Florida, which is right by our friend Dan down in Valley Music Journey down in Florida.
Yeah.
So the point being that we can have our sextants due north and south of each other on that occasion, and measure the distance to the sun. And later I'll visit Florida and do it from, say, just 50 miles north of him, a point in, on the Georgia coast or whatever. But that's a project for the future. If I got enough time, I just, two quick things. Last week I called in and I wanted to make a self-criticism, a correction. I said Rwanda was under United States thumb, as if they control their foreign policy. Not the case. I think Paul Kagame, I've been years since I checked into it, but he's still in power. He's the one that ended the genocide back in the 90s of the Rwanda genocide, Hutus murdering Tutsis, and he's been a overall, I don't get time to go detail, a good president, but I don't know the extent of the NASA stuff, but to the extent that NASA's cooperating with Nigeria and Rwanda, probably Nigeria would be, like I said, the fly technological stuff. But anyway, Rwanda's controlling their own foreign policy. They got Chinese and all. They control their own deal. They're sovereign. And that's how it should be for every country, I believe. And last thing, I just wanted to say, for me in 2022, I study a lot, and a big thing was China and appreciation of the Mao era. And I just ask people, I know China's made some mistakes, such as leading the charge, as Dan pointed out, with the lockdowns and everything worldwide, but they're real good friends with Russia. And in the 60s, the 1960s and 70s, China and Russia hated each other. And I think the Nazis and the Americans all prospered because of that. And over the past few years, they've gotten back together. I think there's good in that. And during the Cultural Revolution, the Chinese government didn't believe the Apollo missions, and they didn't print news about them. They and their friends, the Albanians. And while Russia was degenerate at that time, taking part in the space race, China under Mao Zedong had nothing to do with the space race. As soon as he died, they got on the American capitalist road since 1978 and all throughout the 80s. And that's the reason they have corruption today. When you see people like Fauci and having illicit corruption, it's because when you see corruption in China, it's got an American connection. That's my opinion. So there's a lot of good in China and what they do in Africa and other countries. That's just what I wanted to point. And there's a strata of people in China that are, I'm just saying, don't take a necessarily prejudiced road that attitude. I'm suggesting that everything does is China is bad. They've got some good things. That's all I got.
That's all you got. Okay. Well, thank you, Dennis. That very, very interesting way to end the year. And I hope we do not hear the last from you. And 23, you call back a lot.
Appreciate it. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Yes.
See you, Ben. All right. Let's bring in 845 and tie a bow on this. I gotta remember the song. Oh, right. Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it in 2023.
New York, New York.
What's happening, man?
Vagabond shoes.
They're longing to stray. What's going on, man?
Not much. Getting ready for the new year. I'm going to give my quote now because it's just like, I'm hoping for the new year we can have, I hit the wrong thing. Damn it, I'm on the wrong thing. All right, I'll come back to the quote.
Okay.
Rookie mistake.
No, that's not a rookie mistake. Oh, that's actually fine. That can be, well, go anyway, go ahead.
Well, it was, but I screenshotted the wrong one. I'm a dumbass.
That's right.
I never
use my phone for anything but phone. That's it. And every once in a while to check the time.
Right.
Yeah. Even though I've got clocks all around me, I don't know why I tap the phone.
Right.
Yeah.
You know, you're absolutely right about that. The whole thing, it's all just ridiculous, the CIA. They, like, right in your fucking face, it's totally a cop show, just like all the cop shows ever, to program you into liking cops and being okay with them. You know, sometimes we have to violate their rights to save the world. Right. You know, it's just such fucking programming. Hey. Like, throwing Elon out there. He bought Twitter, and he's telling everybody the truth. And go fuck yourselves.
You know what? That's a great point. Elon the story of the 2022 story that probably bugged me the most was freaking the Elon narrative, which was because he wasn't in tech enough.
Yes.
So it's like, oh no, let's bring him into tech. How? Oh, let's make him own Twitter. Okay. And then just have him just start doing whatever we tell him to do.
Like he's as if he's trying to reveal great truths to the people when this guy is faking space. He sent a freaking Tesla into space to fake it to everybody. He makes these stupid fake rockets. Yeah. I mean, come on. Yeah. He is not on our side.
No, he is not on our side at all. Absolutely at all. I mean, he's worse than the Japanese guy. And again, the from last week, you know, the guy that's going to run the space bus around the moon with all his artists, all those A-listers that he got for the space bus. So
I hope they're playing good beats while they're zipping around.
Dude, they are never.
Be down. That's the least they could do.
You can't run that sort of crowd and try to keep that a secret. Astronauts, that's one thing. Those are military officers that sign away, you know, all their lives. They sign the waivers. They know what they're in for. These guys, these artists, there's no way you could keep them quiet on a fake job. Never, ever happen. Never, ever happen. But no, Elon, I'm hoping, you know, I put in requests. It's like, I'm hoping something horrible happens to him because I just don't like him. I don't. If you're gonna worship somebody, and I know why they're doing it, because Mark Zuckerberg looks like a deer in the headlights constantly, and Elon is the most interesting guy that you have in that world, so that's who you put out front. But let's face it, all you have to do is say, "Oh, look, he's the richest man in the world," and tons of people pay attention to him. Everything he says is notable now because the government pumped.
I saw some guy that was talking about that. They're like, they're coming out with the Neuralink, and now they're going to make blind people see. And now, what is he? Christ? He's like fucking coming here, and
he's
miracles, and
he's Tony Stark without the superhero part. That's all that they try to. Tony Stark. This video,
and maybe you could tell me if this was real. They said they took a 1% solution of nano ribbons and polyethylene glycol and put it into a rat's spine that they clipped.
Right.
And within a couple of days, it started to walk again.
Yeah, whatever. And there's gravitational waves discovered and all sorts of other fun stuff. Tell me when you tested on humans. And by the way, did Elon have anything to do with any of that? No. No. He is literally just a puppet
he's been involved with, wasn't he just propped up and put there? Other people did the shit. They just used his name. They're stuck with that moron.
He's so
brilliant because he bought Twitter. No, he isn't. He didn't even do it.
Bill Burr actually made the same sort of quote about Steve Jobs. You know, where Steve Jobs, he'd walk into a room. It's like, I want to put this entire music collection into this thing right here. Make it happen. Right. And then he'd walk away. And it's like, he didn't do anything. He didn't engineer anything. He just, he just threw the initial concept. It's like, oh, do this. And we'll sell it. Mm-hmm. Whatever. Whatever. Yeah. Elon, the day will come. The bill comes due for everyone, my man. And you got a big bill. It's coming up. Anyway,
eventually. Right?
Anyway, did you have your quote or not?
I'm just, you know what? I got nothing other than, you know, everybody be better. That's it.
All right.
Because the world sucks and they all suck and we just everybody has to be better.
Right. CIA, send me an email. I can give you some tips on some storylines.
You know what? No, there's no unvaxxed people who are testing. That's such bullshit.
Yeah, that is bullcrap. No. You're right. That is true. Because why would you test? I mean, although I will say I have run into a few unvaxxed people that did get the test just for the hell of it, just because of the peer pressure around them. But they didn't do. They don't do it on a regular basis. They did it once, like months ago.
In the beginning, yeah.
It's like all sorts of people because they were curious.
And another thing.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No. Go ahead. You're good.
No, I was just gonna say another thing. You're absolutely right. Don't post shit on social media. They absolutely, everybody looks at it.
Yeah.
Here in New York, for a fact, it is on the pistol permit that you have to list your social account so that they can review them.
Yeah.
They absolutely do it. It's an SOP.
Yeah.
And I say stop doing it unless it's crashing your fucking Hellcat, you moron, because I love watching that shit. Sorry.
Yeah. Let me end with this. If I get an email from an interesting person, sometimes before I write them back, I'll Google them just to see if I can find them. Just to see, it's like, all right, where's this person coming from? Exactly. And if I can do that,
you can find
it without it really much motivation.
Everybody.
Yeah, everybody does it. Everybody does it.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
You can look up anyone. And yeah, ridiculous.
With that, we're gonna wrap this sucker up. Last show of 2022. Thank you guys for listening for the year. 2023 will be next week. And we'll see where it goes. I'm hoping we'll have some better things to talk about. But in the meantime, by the way, thank you for everyone for making people wake up. Big quick shout out to Renee and his team down in Southern California. Had 108 people at the meetup.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, it's not bad for a little regional meetup. So, and those people talk to other people that talk to other people that just keep broadening minds. Science, we're going to win by attrition, but keep doing what you're doing, which is basically nothing. All right. With that, say goodnight. Oh, and I'll be back
next week. Mark.
What?
For another year. And Karen, thank you for another year.
Yeah.
Hey, yeah, man.
That's what we do. In fact, we will be here next week. Same flat time, same flat channel, says Peanut, nods in a cloud of smoke. Say goodnight, Karen.
Goodnight, Karen.
Say goodnight, Zulu.
Good night, Zulu.
And roll the final music of the year. And hot sex.
Hot sex.
Last hot sex.
Happy fake Gregorian New Year.
There you go. It's not 2022, by the way, if you guys didn't figure it out. Not even close. More than double that in China, the Middle East, you know, the old places.
The Jews. Like 5,000 something.
Are we allowed to say that?
I didn't say anything bad.
You're right. That's not bad.
It's like almost, they're like almost up to year 6,000. So why, you know, what's going on here?
All right. Good night, everybody.
Fought in many wars, dance our lives away. I you'll ever need.